Anyone who's seen any of the previous see-through engine episodes knows I was trying to blow this engine up for a while and I was unsuccessful. So when someone requested that I run this engine on black powder, I thought it was a great idea. The only issue I'm gonna have is going to be the method of delivery, since gunpowder has its own oxygen. If not done right, this can be really dangerous. So I reached out to my guy at Project Farm, since he's like an expert at rigging things up. And while he just started cracking up laughing, after a short conversation with him, I think I figured out how I can make this work. It looks like I'm all set. I got my seal on the tube that's creating a complete seal with the carburetor. As soon as I hit the switch on the remote here, it's gonna move a tube full of black powder into position and make a connection between the tube and the carburetor of the engine and just let the engine suck in as much gunpowder as it wants. What can go wrong? All right, here we go. I'm gonna start it up on gasoline real quick, just let it run. Hear how this thing sounds and see how well the carburetor works. First thing I'm gonna do is I bolted on the stock head. I'm just gonna run it on gasoline real quick to do a quick test run, make sure that all my linkages are working properly and they're not binding. I have a linkage for my throttle and a linkage for the tube that's gonna be full of black powder. That's it. This should be good. Never done this before. Let's do the first run on gasoline and see how this little beast sounds. All right, cool. Seems like the thing runs really good on gasoline. Let me get the head bolted on, fill this tube up with gunpowder. Man, this is finally ready. This was a lot of building to make it look nice and clean and operate smoothly. Next, I'm gonna mount a see-through head, just like the very first see-through engine I ever did. All right, we're ready to rock and roll. I'm all set. Let's see what this engine does. This is unknown territory for me. I've never done this before. And this is exactly why I take all of the safety precautions that I do. I mean, that was crazy. That was a double explosion. First, the engine blew, and then a little ember flew inside of the tube and ignited the rest of the gunpowder, and the tube blew up. A double explosion. That was insane and definitely not what I expected. But check out that damage. Man, that was a crazy explosion. That reminds me of like those cartoons where you know, they bend the pistol backwards and the whole pistol explodes. That's kind of how it looks here. Look at those head bolts. It bent all of the head bolts completely out of place. And yeah, that was nuts. There's just one little piece of the see-through head left. And if you look inside of that cylinder, I mean, it even bent the aluminum plate, my spacer plate, right there. If you look at that, look at that. It even bent the entire aluminum plate. Wow, that was impressive. That was pretty cool. I think I'm gonna throw on the stock head and see if this thing would start up one more time. I mean, that would prove this Briggs & Stratton to be indestructible. The shock of that explosion was so intense, it also bent my intake manifold. Look at that. Yeah, that was pretty crazy. So that being said, I think what I'm gonna do as a testament to Briggs & Stratton, because these engines obviously are just about indestructible, I'm gonna remove these bolts, bolt the stock head back on, see if I can get it to run one more time as an outro. I want to give a shout out to John from Bird Engines in Chicago. Every time we're in the middle of filming and I need a part or something randomly, he always hooks me up. Super nice guy. And on top of that, I want to mention one other thing. I always ask everybody's opinions about my videos and everything that I put on YouTube, simply because I feel that the audience is a part of these stories and these projects and what I put together. And I'm kind of like just the guy that builds them to show everybody. That's just how I feel. So this particular episode, I filmed with a completely different camera up until these scenes right now. And I just want to ask everybody's opinion as to what they think about the look of the video, or if the video felt any different to you. And yeah, I just want to end it right there. And thanks again for watching. I'll see you real soon. See you in the next video.
Take me back to the nights we felt alive, picking up the pieces on a summer night. I didn't know that I would feel just like my heart's on fire whenever I'm with you. Cause we go back in time to thrills I miss and all the things I wish we did. All I know is that I need somebody like you. Cause I can't waste another night sitting here alone, hoping for your voice on the telephone. I know it's a supercut as you walk away, playing in my mind all the things I never closed my eyes.